Well, hey everybody, good morning to you all. I'm gonna get ready and head out and go and feed and water the birds. And with it being a beautiful day out today, I'm gonna head out and go and cut firewood after I get done doing the birds. And I think it's just an unusual nice day today for the considered the time of year it is, because January and February is usually the coldest time in the winter. I'm gonna get wood cut up and all that, so that way it'll be done and out of the way. I'm probably gonna go out and try and clean up some of that snow in front of the mailbox late, you know, at some point in time today. I'm not sure when. So that way it'll make it easier for the mailman to get up to the mailbox, because of not shoveling out in front of it like I'm supposed to be, and it's starting to create a mound of hard packed snow right there, and makes it harder for the mailman to get up to the mailbox. So I'm gonna let you guys go for now and talk to you guys later. Oh yeah, got windows open and stuff today, so that should tell you how nice of a day it is today. There's one window open and there's the door open. Of course, Sammy, he's been going in and out. He hasn't been going any further than off the porch. He's never really been outside before, so it's all new to him being able to go out on the porch. But I'll take you guys out there with me while I feed and water the birds. So I'm going to let you guys go for now so that way I can get water and get ready to head out and do that. And I'll meet you guys out there. Good luck. All right, everybody. I'm out here at the chicken coop. I just got the side opened up and getting ready to feed them right now. So I'm going to start getting their food down to them, and that way they can have their food. But here they are. They let me pet them and stuff. They weren't like that at first when, you know, didn't like me petting them, but since I'm out here every day and I'm always dealing with them, they're getting a lot more friendlier. Well, say hello. Say hello. Where's the big guy at? Oh, he's way back in there. There he is. Say hello. Nope, can't go outside, baby girl. Gotta stay in here. Not allowed to go outside. Well, not if you're shouting that out here anyway. Well, they're wanting their food, so I'm gonna get them their food. There. Maybe we spill a little bit right there, but that's all right. They'll still get it. As long as they got their food, that's the point of it, right? And the water's not frozen, but it's starting to get a little murky from them. Yeah, a little murky, definitely dirty. Now time for their eggshells. There's all the mounds of ice I've dumped out over so far over the winter from their water. The water likes to freeze. Okay, now they got their eggshells. I was getting a hell of a collection of that shit going on. Now it's time for their fresh water. That's going in right now. So that way they have it. There. Fresh water, food. Like I said, they made me spill some right there, but that's okay because they'll still eat it. And otherwise, that's where the rest of their food's at, right back in there. Alright, well, I'm going to try and climb in here and get their eggs out. Because otherwise they try and get out of the pen if you don't feed them first. So, you have to feed them first. Alright, there, now I'm in. Four eggs there. I finally laid one down in there. They've only been laying 5 eggs lately. Other than that, they haven't been laying anymore. So I'm gonna start collecting up their eggs. Alright, now it's time to shuffle the straw around a little bit. See if there's any other eggs. And way back here along the wall, I got a feel. Also, way back in here, I got a feel, because sometimes they'll lay them so far back in here that they'll roll off this little lip and sit between this wall and this board here. So I always have to feel back in there, make sure they don't got nothing. They usually don't lay their eggs anywhere else but right here usually. Every once in a while I might find an egg down in here. But I know the red light kind of messes with the camera a little bit. Yeah, I'm going to have to let you guys go to where I can dig through the straw down on the bottom there a little bit. Make sure I got them all. Make sure they didn't bury any. And I always look down in here, but for me spreading the straw out and stuff, it don't sit out as far as it used to. So I had to break the bale of straw open. What are you getting mouthy for? Huh? What are you getting mouthy for? Yep, he likes to get mouthy every once in a while. Alright, well, I'm gonna let you guys go for now. Talk to you later. See you shortly later on down the road. Not much going on, just doing my chores right now. Well, hey everybody, I'm back again. I'm getting ready to go out and cut up some firewood. Tennille's not home from work yet. Somebody called in, so she had to work a longer shift. She was originally scheduled to work 4 hours today, and somebody called in and not coming in to work again today. So she has to work until about 6. So when she gets home, we're going to be heading to town to go to Family Dollar, fill up her gas tank and stuff before she got gas. And right now I'm getting ready to go out and cut up firewood, so I'm going to take the GoPro out with me and get some footage of me cutting up firewood again. So I'll see you guys out there. I'm getting ready to head out right now. It's starting to get later in the day. It's 5 minutes to 5 right now. So I'm going to get out there and get wood cut up before it gets too late, so that way I don't piss off any of the next door neighbors from cutting up firewood too late. So I'll end up seeing you guys out there here in a minute. I'm heading out right now. It's I just opened up the door to see if it was still fairly decent out. So I'm going to head out there and not wear my jacket and get the wood cut up.
So here we are at Tom's, and Don ran into somebody he knows, but we're gonna get some groceries. I just got out of work. I had to stay late because of another call-in, the same girl again, but that's okay. So we get here and Don starts putting all this cereal, like all those boxes, and those boxes too, in the cart. I'm like, you can have one, but you don't need them all. Come on. And Spartan cereal's on sale, 3 for $5. So this is yet. Number one.
This is how you solve the problem. Stick your arm in here. Just start wiping everything right off the shelf right down on the curtain.
Oh.
As you're walking along.
Jeez. Actually, I don't know about... These are the honey ones. I might just get the normal ones. Yeah, these are good, but there's a lot of sugar. I don't need the apple cinnamon ones either. I'm sure that's bad too. Oh, good. Yeah, that's even more sugar. Gotta find the normal Cheerios and not drop shit on the floor. So we're home now, and I got more healthy food. This is the skim milk. Don was gonna put it away, but now he's not going to. Until I started filming.
Filming what?
There's these vegetables. These vegetables. These vegetables. Nothing in here. I found the Cheerios, so I got two boxes of those. And then one box of Rice Krispies. And those don't have a lot of calories or sugar or fat or nothing. And I needed sandwich bags for my sandwiches I'd take to work. And those were on sale, so there you go. Jeez, Tug! And then this is... Oh, that's Don's bag of sugar. And I got a bag of apples, Red Delicious apples, the only ones I really like.
And a banana.
And oranges, and I guess this is my banana too.
Yeah, but one problem.
What?
When you stretch condom over them to use them for sexual pleasures, don't be so damn rough with the damn things, because that's what happens.
This is not...
And then when you get too rough, they turn into mush.
You're gross. So anyway, we stopped and got gas at the Shell station on the way home, and I went inside and I got this iced coffee, which is only 50 calories per bottle, and I drank this all through the time that I was losing 150 pounds. A combination of this and the McDonald's caramel iced coffee, the small size. And I was fine. So this is one thing I can have. But anyway, I got two bananas, and I ate one on the way home. One for Don and one for me, and now he doesn't want his banana. So I guess I have a banana for tomorrow. You're telling me you never want this banana?
Well, I tried telling you that you eat the damn thing, but you said nope, that you used it for sexual pleasures.
I didn't say that. Bananas have a lot of calories. And there's some asshole on a snowmobile running through our backyard.
No, it was on the trail.
Well, it's still basically the backyard. Can't see it, but we could hear it. And then the last thing is this bag of oranges. So.
Well, the backyard is the side that you're facing. That's the backyard.
No, that's where the road is. That's the front yard. You're backwards in your mind.
There's a reason why I put this fucking piece of shit house trailer in the way I put it in.
You put it in backwards.
This could be the front yard. Not that.
No, the yard isn't backwards. The house is backwards. You got the back door facing the front of the house and the front door facing out of the back of the house.
No, I put it in here like this for a reason.
The front yard is still the front yard and the backyard is still the backyard. You can't change that. You can't turn the earth around.
This is the front of the house.
Yes?
The tongue's up there. The ass end's back there.
That just means you turn the house around backwards.
Yeah, so that way this can be the front yard.
No, that's still the backyard. And the front yard is still the front yard. There's nothing you can do to change that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I've been calling this
turning your house around backwards.
I've been calling this fucking front yard for over 8 years now.
Yeah, but
you're gonna tell me how it should be?
Yes, because I face reality. Turning your house around backwards does not switch the front yard and the backyard around.
Well,
that just doesn't work.
Well, you know what? The day I fucking die, you can take a forklift, turn this cocksucker around where you can face the road then.
I don't want it turned around. It's just you're standing at the back door and the other door is the front door.
No.
And you made it that way by flipping the house around backwards.
No, it's not backwards.
Yes, you put it on
the
property
the front
backwards.
Yard.
No, that's the backyard.
No, it's the front yard.
Whatever. You win. Well, hey, Sammy, what do you want? You want my apples? You don't like apples. You're a cat. You don't like apples either, Tug. Every time I try to give you fruit, even bananas, you won't eat them. You don't like fruit. So get out of here. And here's dinner. Vegetables, chicken breast, baked, mashed potatoes, made healthy, and still leftover turkey gravy. And that's all, and I'll track it and I'll see where I am, because I don't think I went over today. So I just got off the bike, and I'm going to eat an apple and an orange for dessert. And then my calories will be good for the day. Right, Tug? Goofball? And you're just standing there.
Well, don't be picking on my dog.
Hey, you always say he's my dog, and that Sammy's my cat.
Only when he's bad, he's your dog.
Oh, I got this one on film.
Yep.
You're claiming that these are your pets, too.
Nope, just Tug.
Next time you say that they're just your dog and Sammy's just your cat,
nope.
I'm going to play this vlog for you.
Nope, you can have Sammy.
Right? You guys can't talk to be witnesses, but this footage can.
But guess what? Tug's only mine when he's good. When he's rotten, he's yours.
Oh, whatever.
Well, he's being rotten.
You're a witness too, right, Sammy? And so is the whole internet. So we caught him red-handed on this one.
Nope, he's my dog when he's good, and he's your dog when he's horrible.
Yeah, right.
So I guess you have to pay back all the money on the vet bill.
Yeah, well, I'm the one who's paying to get Sammy neutered, and I paid for 30 pounds of food for him.
Yeah, your point is...
Who paid for the last dog food? Didn't I pay for the last dog food?
Yeah, but...
Yeah, see?
But stop thinking about how many bags did I pay for.
Yeah, but I paid for plenty of dog food and cat food, and I paid for some litter, and I'm the one who always buys him treats, and I bought the clippers for Sammy, and I bought Tug's brush, and I bought the collars for him, and the harness for Tug, and I'm the one who paid for their ID tags.
Well, that's only goes to show how well I'm starting to get you trained.
Yeah?
Yeah. Now I just gotta get you trained where if I say, oh, I'm hot, you just automatically get up and turn on the fan, and you get all almost back over there, and you're like, whoa. I wasn't hot. I guess he's getting me trained.
Oh, you're strange.
Want to see something strange?
What?
Go and look in the fucking mirror.
Oh, thanks a lot. So we're on episode 2 of the Freak Show episode. And I paused it here. Season 4. So that we can finish it. And as you can see, they brought Pepper back. But I don't think her name is Pepper. But of course, any American Horror Story fans know that's a normal-looking woman in makeup. And there's Evan Peters again, the guy who played Tate at the beginning. And I just think that it's really cool that every season is a totally different story, but it's the same actors playing totally different characters, and they do such a good job that their characters are not alike. So that's pretty cool. But I work one more day, and then I have a day off. And I'm going to go ahead and edit this. So we're going to say goodnight, and we hope that you enjoyed the video, and you like, subscribe, comment, share, and you're having a good night.
Oh, fuck that dumb shit.
Oh, whatever.
Slap the thumbs down and unsubscribe.
Some people are doing that. Apparently people don't like our vlogs. We're getting a lot of dislikes lately.
Oh, well.
So, oh well, too bad.
If they don't like Magway, ask them. They don't need to watch.
Well, like I said, I'm not Charles Trippy or Shay Carroll or any of those people who can run around and do something cool and expensive every day. So it is what it is.
Well, you gotta be rich to get people to like you.
Yeah, apparently.
If your property's struck in, it's fuck you.
Yeah, you gotta be able to go to Disney World every day or Universal Studios every day.
Yep.
So, but whatever.
Well, the government's trying to make it to where Michigan's fucking all upper class.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, they've been trying to do that for years. They've been trying to drive out all the fucking poor.
Huh.
Well, haven't driven me out yet, and I'm poor.
Yeah, it's not working.
Well, if that keeps me from being poor, then I'm not dumb and fucking going to blow my money on fucking stupid shit. At least if I go and blow my money on something that's on property and shit.
Yeah. Well, say goodnight.
Good morning.
Good night, Tug. Bye-bye, Tug. Bye-bye. And Sammy's in his food bowl, so... Bye-bye, Tug.